October 16th, somewhere near the Pamba River at the edge of the Pathanamitta Forest, 24-year-old journalist Kavita Jakala, wearing military clothes and helmet, was being escorted by the police towards the steps of the Sabarimala Temple. On seeing a woman, a devotee coming down the temple stairs, "It's too dangerous to proceed further tonight."
"But this journey needs to be completed now."
"We will provide you with full protection in the morning." 300 policemen accompanied Kavita the next morning, but hundreds of devotees stood in her way. "We will not allow any woman to enter the temple." Head priest Kandararu Rajaviru warned the posse of policemen, "If she enters the temple, I will close the gates and stop puja." Despite a Supreme Court order of September 2018 permitting women of menstruating age to enter the temple, it violates Article 25(1) of the Constitution. It's also a violation of the fundamental rights to equality. Males cannot be allowed to dominate in the practice of devotion. On his birthday 82 years ago, in 1936, a worried Maharaja of Travancore had boldly changed another Sabarimala tradition.
"Dalits are leaving the Hindu fold in the hundreds. I must do something to stop this exodus."
"From now on, doors of Sabarimala will be open to our Dalit brothers." Like now, there was a serious backlash at the time. His own aunt refused to visit the temple. And while he maintained control over his own state, his neighbor, the Maharaja of Cochin, priest from Travancore, can no longer serve in our lands. The people of Travancore are themselves untouchable like the Dalits. History repeats itself. Over 5,000 people have been arrested by the Kerala police in the statewide protest against the verdict. Swami Sandipananda Giri, the lone religious liberal who had the courage to back the Supreme Court verdict, had his ashram attacked. People are using religion for their politics. So unpopular among the devotees was this decision that even some women devotees took to the streets, blocking the path of reformists.
"Why do you want to go into the temple? Maintain tradition."
The tradition is for devotees to undergo a 41-day penance to be considered sufficiently pure to pray at the temple. The penance includes vegetarian diet, no sex, no alcohol, no cutting of bodily hair. Since a woman goes through her monthly period at least once in 41 days, they are automatically disqualified from performing the penance. The closest where women were traditionally allowed to go was to a point near the Pampa River, 6 to 8 kilometers from the temple, after which only males were allowed to continue the journey. So widespread is the belief of menstrual impurity among traditional homes in Kerala.
"Till your period is over, you cannot enter the kitchen or even your own bedroom."
In the early days, Sabarimala was a secret place, accessible only to true devotees who knew the protocols to be followed.
"I am going to Ayyappan temple. You take care of house and children."
As its fame grew, people from neighboring states began coming for pilgrimage. Slowly, these protocols began to break.
"I have to get back to office next week. I cannot undertake a 41-day penance."
With 5.5 crore of 55 million devotees going to Sabarimala every year, the temple became a picnic spot for some. Soon film stars and politicians started visiting the temple. Even a song in Tamil movie, Nambinar Kedduvathilai, was filmed with actor Jayashree singing on the 18 sacred steps leading to the shrine. Women from elite families belonging to the band age group of menstruating women openly flouted rules. Journalist AP Joy, who happened to witness them, kicked away, despite being offered a handsome reward for the snaps.
"Here, take 50,000 rupees. Give me the film roll and don't say word to anyone."
He refused and instead gave it for free to 15 newspapers, all of whom published them. The next morning when S. Mahendran, a secretary at a library, saw them, he filed a petition in the Kerala High Court using the photographs as proof.
"Special treatment is being given to wives of VIPs. This is against the custom of the temple."
In response to the PIL by Mahendran, a two-judge bench of the Kerala High Court in 1991,
"Restriction on women's entry into Sabarimala does not violate constitutional rights."
15 years later, six women lawyers filed a petition in the Supreme Court to lift the ban on women devotees at Sabarimala.
"It does violate the right to equality guaranteed under the Constitution."
Since 2016, Indian courts have been on a reforming spree. giving judgments against discriminatory religious practices, as in the triple talaq matter and on the entry of women to the Haji Ali Dargah. See Bisbo's story. Even the Shani Shingapur temple in Ahmednagar was ordered by the court in 2016 to permit entry to women devotees into the temple.
Though we are not being permitted inside the sanctum sanctorum.
Many temples across India still do not allow entry to women. They may face legal challenges in the coming days. However, the Supreme Court's ruling was not a unanimous decision. Ironically, it was a woman judge who dissented.
In a secular country, issues of deep religious faith and sentiments must not ordinarily be interfered by court.
The question that begs an answer is this. Why is it that other than pilgrimage season or Mandala Kalam from November to January, women of all ages are allowed entry into Sabarimala? Women of the so-called banned ages have been going inside the Sabarimala temple before for the choroonu ceremony or the first meal eating ceremony for children sitting on the laps of their mother, a tradition that continues today. TKA Nair, principal secretary to Dr. Manmohan Singh, was one of them. The A in his name stands for Ayappan Kutti, with Kutti meaning child. Traditions evolve, and right now, one such evolution is taking place. Over time, most Hindu shrines, especially those associated with the Shakta tradition, abandon animal sacrifice. In many temples, it is no longer considered obligatory to have worship conducted by Brahmin priests. Kerala's focus right now needs to be on rebuilding after the devastating floods. Instead, the whole focus has shifted to politics. See Bisbo's story of the Kerala floods. Sabarimala is one of the highest revenue generating temples, with annual donations of about 230 crore or $70 million. Others are Shirdi, Mumbai, 700 crores, Tirupati, Andhra Pradesh, 650 crore, Vaishno Devi, Jammu, 500 crore, Siddhi Vinayak, Mumbai, 125 crore. With general elections approaching, the BJP hopes for a new Ayodhya issue to keep itself in power.
If Kerala government does not stop suppressing devotees, BJP workers will bring down this government.
Demonstrations against the government were widespread across the state. However, BJP's agitation doesn't seem to be getting it any extra votes. In the December by-elections, BJP got just 2 seats, with the current LDF government winning 21, including the area of Sabarimala. Congress-led UDF won 12. Tradition and culture makes India a rich nation, but these elements need to be balanced with the changing world. Now that the courts have ruled, they must enforce their decision or revisit it, else the authority of the judiciary will be eroded. Bisbo's limerick. The Sabarimala temple has been open to women. For traditional devotees, this is a strange phenomenon. They rant and they rave and badly behave. Going against the Supreme Court is not a good omen.
Subscribe to Bisbo's channel
and be sure to click on the bell icon.
Be the first to know when Bisbo releases a new video.